The United Kingdom continues to face a range of terrorist threats. CONTEST is the government's counter-terrorism strategy, aims to reduce the risk from terrorism and the extremism that lies behind it. The strategy is divided into four areas. Pursue, which aims to detect and disrupt those individuals who are intent on carrying out an attack. Protect and prepare, which aims to reduce the impact should an attack occur. And prevent, which aims to stop people becoming terrorists or being drawn into terrorism. Terrorist groups seek to recruit and radicalise people towards their cause. Therefore, prevent is seen as a vital strand of the CONTEST strategy.
Here in the East Midlands, work around prevent continues to go from strength to strength, with police and partners from various sectors, including education, criminal justice, faith, charities, health, local and district councils and many others, as well as local communities, continue to work together to highlight where there are risks of radicalisation and to provide practical help to prevent individuals from being drawn into terrorism and ensure that they are given appropriate advice and support. This short film aims to give you an insight into how prevent works in the East Midlands and to highlight the need for us to continue to work together to keep our young people and our communities safe from this threat.
Your government's prevent strategies is important certainly for all sections of community because it does not only emphasize and look at religion in the background but far right and other extremist groups that exist out there. I think it's important that the community understand that prevent is something that stands in the pre-criminal stage. Therefore, we're looking at vulnerability in people, and if we find vulnerability among our young people, then it's only right that we try and steer them away from violent extremism. Therefore, I think the program is extremely important in relation to the security of our country and our nation. And I think we should all work together, bearing in mind that looking at the issue, it is looked from a prevention point of view as opposed to pursue, which is often misunderstood by the vast majority of people.
We need to educate and raise awareness about prevent, what prevent really is about. I think people think it's about police kicking doors in and arresting people, and actually it's about supporting all of our vulnerable people and providing packages of support if people need help with problems in ideologies they're facing or getting involved in groups of activity that becomes dangerous or harmful to them. So from that end, I see it as a safeguarding remit.
Prevent is often and can be seen wrongly as being highlighting or focusing on one community, and intrinsically that's wrong. We're about, or prevent is around, entirely dealing with extremism in all its forms across all sectors and groups.
I think there's lots communities can do to eliminate discrimination, extreme violence and terrorism. The first thing, I think it's a case of doing a lot of reflection. What is it that we see as the problem, and how can we help those, for example, such as the police service, which is a fantastic service. How can we help them to better police our communities and help our citizens? And indeed, I think the prevent agenda is so principally important that we prevent rather than cure. So if we can prevent our young people being drawn to any form of violence, whether it's hate crimes or whether it's, worse still, is acts of terrorism, I think the communities must work. And likewise, there's an onus on the police service, and I've seen this, working closely with our communities, particularly those that are less privileged.
For prevent to really succeed, we really need to embrace the partnership working that we've got going. So all the statutory bodies, all the partners that are out there, even the voluntary sector, bringing those partners around the table, giving them a voice in the strategy so they can help shape the strategy and help us to help them with the wider community as well. So the partnership working is key, the communities are key, and it's about everyone coming around that table and everyone having the discussions, answering some questions that might be uncomfortable for us, for all of us, but being honest with those answers and working together to resolve them and challenge the narrative that exploits some of these grievances.
Relationship building in communities is extremely important because it's part of the solution to the problem, that we can tackle this together. So this is not something that City Council and the police and others can solve without having proper dialogue with all sorts of different people in different communities. And communities need to stand up together to fight extremism.
Partnership working is Prevent. Prevent is all around relationships. It is about working with a broad range of voluntary, statutory agencies and any other groups and individuals out in the community to deliver Prevent, which is institutionally and actually around safeguarding vulnerable individuals and stopping the threat of terrorism and the narratives that are allowed in our communities to drive and radicalise people towards more harmful ends.
I think one message from me around Prevent and to the wider audience is it's everybody's business. It should be considered an issue like safeguarding and incorporated into those the way of looking at a vulnerability, really. It's definitely not a one agency approach. And actually what we're looking at is some of the most vulnerable, particularly for us young people. And we need to just really make sure that we're ready to respond to those so that people are well aware of, you know, looking for risk factors and thinking something's not quite right and having the confidence and ability to kind of do something with that.
The role of schools, an educational establishment in preventing violence, hatred, is critical. We have some fantastic teaching taking place every day in our schools, but we need to build upon that. We can't become complacent. And we are knowing and familiar with the fact that there's racism, there's homophobia, and there's all sorts of other discriminations taking place. And there's, of course, Islamophobia and xenophobia, and all these things impact on our young people. And so as wise custodians, it is on us to follow the best.
It's really important for the university to be involved in all things Prevent, because, you know, one of the particular concerns for an institution like ours, and, you know, we recruit a lot of students who aren't necessarily from traditional backgrounds heading into higher education. So in some cases, we can be recruiting individuals from more vulnerable backgrounds. And really, any vulnerability obviously can lead to a susceptibility to some of the issues that are arising through the Prevent agenda. So it's really important for us to understand how vulnerability can lead to issues around Prevent and make those connections.
A woman, a mother, or is it, she's, I mean, a mother in Islam or as a Muslim, as any society, is the key. She's the person that keeps that family together, and she will pick up on it. I know I've got three sons, and I know their moods. I know they get up in the morning. I know they're sitting quiet. I know there's something or what's matter. You immediately pick up on if there's something bothering them, something's wrong. And if we've educated these women and we've told them and we've made them feel comfortable around the words and everything, work of the violent extremist terrorism, they will, obviously, when they're comfortable themselves, and if they see something that's not appropriate, or even in their husbands, they will be able to, and they'll know that the right thing to do is to seek help.
County Council have used the RAP2 training programme, which is produced by the Home Office. And it's a range of staff have been on that, from frontline business support staff to social workers. And it's important that they have that training so that the awareness is raised, and they are then able to take that back out into their communities, into their work life, and spot those triggers of people who are vulnerable and make sure they know the right processes to put them in the right place for support. It's very informative. It makes people think about the activities that they're undertaking and how they can spot people who are becoming radicalised. Staff who've been on this training inside local authority have suddenly realised what a role they can play, and this training enables them to understand that role.
I thought the prospect of going to a counter-terrorism workshop was rather bizarre, to be honest. I didn't quite know how it would be relevant to me or to my work.
I think also kind of in the role we work in, being kind of quite customer focused, dealing a lot with the general public, it's something that we are the first point of contact. So I think that's very relevant to kind of remember that we are coming into contact with a lot of people, and being able to pick up any kind of indicators or anything you're not quite sure about. I think it gave us information around that, definitely. I think it's essential, I would go as far as saying that, that anyone who comes into contact with the general public, especially frontline services, is something, it's to raise awareness. And the more knowledge people have around these things, the better equipped they are to make that referral, to make that judgment. So, and again, it was a very interesting workshop, and I think frontline workers would definitely benefit from that.
Yeah.
Channel is a programme that works with all sorts of agencies to assist people with whatever their vulnerabilities are. So it may start off as an issue to do with extremism and terrorism, but what we will do is ensure that we can put support and wrap around an individual, whether that's because they have a housing need, or whether they need support within the school, or whether they need to access into some form of training opportunity, or even that they've not been provided with adequate healthcare. We can make sure of those things happen around them, and we work together effectively to do that.
The East Midlands Community Contact Unit set up 4 years ago. It was a result of the need for bespoke intervention in respect of people who are vulnerable to violent extremism in the East Midlands. And since that time, we've developed a cadre of providers who can give positive intervention to young people who are vulnerable to that extremism.
I got to a situation where I couldn't live with myself, with my ideologies and what I was doing, and I basically ended up having a nervous breakdown. I was taken to a mental health unit where I was secured, which then started to give me a chance to unravel all the stuff in my head. Extreme far-right ideology, the things I was involved with, were as far right as they can be, and I think it got to a point where, like a cancer, just developed. It got hold of me and I couldn't cope anymore. I'd been involved in a violence which eventually led to my enrolment in the far right over roughly a 26 year period, so it pretty much become a lifestyle, a mission, a cause. I think the first thing was I was taken out of the equation. The second thing was I was given a couple of mentors from the EMCCU, who one of them in fact is an Asian guy, but these two guys really helped me to start to unpick all of my racist far-right views. They never judged me, they allowed me to talk, and I think we both ended up learning a lot from each other. I didn't realise it at the time, but it was part of the Prevent and Channel programme, and my mentors went way above their job remit, and in fact so much so that if it wasn't for these guys in my life, I don't think I'll be here now.
When I was 15 years old, I converted to Islam. Just before my 16th birthday, my parents kicked me out of the house, so to find help I went to the local mosque, where I was taken in by a Muslim family. After spending some time with this family, I noticed that they were trying to kind of put some views on me that I'd never heard of before. All the views at first didn't seem too radical, but then I started to notice after time that they were getting like more and more radical, more and more kind of, you know, extreme. After a while at the house, I felt it was time to move on, and the family agreed with me as well. After I left the house, I found myself in a youth hostel, and I found that this family that had fed me for 2 months had cut me off, didn't want anything to do with me anymore. It hit me even more because it felt like it was all happening to me again. Then I found myself going further downhill. I found myself getting detached from the religion and the community that had brought me into Islam. I found myself taking drugs, getting worse and worse, until I was on hard drugs. Then I moved out of the youth hostel and found myself living in single accommodation. There things really went downhill for me, as I didn't feel I had anyone to turn to. I didn't even feel that I had my God to turn to. That's when the East Midlands Community Contact Unit stepped in, and they give me a lot of support. They did a lot for me and they're still doing a lot for me today, and it's been nearly a year now. At first they took it step by step. Because I was on drugs, they managed to get me off the drugs, and they managed to get me back into the youth hostel. They managed to get me into college. They give me a lot of support. They come to see me at least twice a week. They were ringing me more or less every day, checking to see if everything was okay and I was all right. This carried on for a year and it's still carrying on today. If it weren't for the channel process, I don't know where I could have been today. There's so many possibilities. I could have either gone two ways. I could have either been on really hard drugs, or I could have been in Palestine, Somalia, or Syria, or some other place where a lot of radical extremism is going off.
Prevent is received with mixed blessings, certainly within the community that I work in. There are those that still feel that it is spying on the community, but the vast majority have now understood that it has nothing to do with that particular strand. It has to do with protecting our community. And if we are concerned about young people and the future generation that is going to grow up in this country, then I think we need to pursue. It's no different to, say, knife crime, drugs, etc. It's just one of the other strands of vulnerability that people tap into. And it has more to do with the geopolitical structure of the world as opposed to the religious. And I think we need to move away by thinking that it has to do anything with the belief system of Muslims. It has more to do with the political side of Islam, which is something that is totally different.
So Prevent is about working together, relationships, trust and confidence, and our collective ability to recognise a problem and find a solution.
Here in the East Midlands, we've seen what is happening in Derbyshire, Leicestershire, Lincolnshire, Nottinghamshire and Northamptonshire, and the difference that is being made through discussion, positive relationships and working together to recognise and support the vulnerable.
So Prevent is about you. It's about me. It's about all of us.